Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Savita. First, I would like to thank all my subscribers. Your comments and feedback are really very encouraging and motivating me to do more projects that are unique and easy DIY. Previously, I have posted a video about an under budget and easy to build wall hanging, and today's video is also a very easy DIY project. I'm going to make a decorative centerpiece flower vase using some bottles and wood cuttings. Since this is an easy project, do watch it and try it out. Now let's go into the video to see how to make this.
I have three clear glass bottles. These are sugarcane juice bottles that I had purchased from Indian grocery store. I have removed the label stickers and washed it thoroughly. If you don't have these bottles, you can use any other bottles. This project needs 1 inch by 3 inch common wooden board. I need to drill 3 holes on this boards. The holes should be wide enough to hold the neck of the bottle. To drill the holes on the wooden board, I need a hole saw or circular drill bit. It comes in different sizes. Depending on the width of the bottleneck, select the appropriate size. Since the first one turned out to be a bit larger, I have chosen the next smaller size bit to drill the holes. Next step is to prepare the frame. Position the bottles on the wooden board and mark the required length. For this particular size of the bottle, I have marked 14 inches. Now locate and mark the center at 7 inches for the bottle that goes in the middle. Then mark the points to place the other two bottles with about 2 inches of gap on each side. Before start drilling the holes, place a piece of waste wood below the wooden board to avoid damage to your work table. Place the drill bit on the point marked and drill the hole. You also need to be extra careful that the piece of wood being drilled is firmly positioned, as it will tend to turn along the direction of the drill and could cause injuries. So fasten the board if possible using clamps to hold it tight. Remove the cut circular wooden piece from the saw using a screwdriver or chisel and push it out. After drilling all the three holes, sand the edges to a smooth finish using a sandpaper. Next, I'm cutting the wooden board to a length of 14 inches. You can do this cut using handsaw or jigsaw. I have used a miter saw to make this cut. This piece is for the top. I need the same length for the bottom as well. Once you cut both the top and the bottom pieces, position the bottles and measure the length for the sides of the frame. It measures 7 inches and I have cut 2 wooden pieces for both the sides. If you can cut the edges at a 45 degree angle, the joints and the final finish will appear more professional. Since some of you may not have the necessary tools to make this cut, I have done this with straight cuts. Before bringing the pieces together, I would like to stain them first. I'm using dark walnut. You could alternatively choose to paint instead of stain to the color of your choice. Wear a pair of gloves and use a piece of sponge to apply the stain. I applied 2 coats of stain and allowed it to dry. In the meantime, I have prepared the bottles for decoupage. First, apply 2 coats of chalk paint on the bottle and allow it to dry between the coats. I am using a color oatmeal from Focart. This is totally optional. You can use the bottle as is or you can decorate the bottles as you wish. You can paint something like a dog painting or any Indian folk art painting to give an ethnic look. But I'm going to do decoupage to give a little modern look. In order to decoupage, you will need Mod Podge. You can find this in any store in the art and craft section. You will also need printed tissue paper. I bought this from a dollar store. You would need just 2 to 3 of them for this project. While the bottles are drying, we can prepare the tissue paper. First, separate the 2 plies of the tissue paper and cut out the designs. Hand-torn pieces look best instead of using scissors. I have cut out the designs from 2 of the sheets and I think that is more than enough for the 3 bottles. Once the paint on the bottles has dried, use a paintbrush and apply the Mod Podge on the surface of the bottle liberally and stick a piece of the cut out designs. It is impossible to avoid wrinkles on the tissue paper, but try to avoid it as much as possible. Be very gentle while sticking the tissue paper on the bottles. Once the papers are firmly stick on the bottle, apply another coat of Mod Podge over the tissue papers. Don't be in rush while applying the coats. Work on small areas and stick the tissue paper to the bottles to cover the bottle with the designs on the tissue paper. Follow the same procedure as I have explained. Apply the Mod Podge, stick the tissue paper, and again apply the Mod Podge over the tissue paper till you cover the bottles. I did this for all the 3 bottles and allowed it to dry. Meanwhile, outside my garage, my husband is painting our newly installed garage door and my little one is also helping him. It is good to let kids to participate in activities like this. This will motivate them to learn and fix things by themselves as they grow up. Now back to the project, both the wood and the bottles have dried. I am giving a protective coat using water-based polyurethane to protect them from water damage and allowing that to dry as well. After the polyurethane coat has dried, it is time to fix all the wood pieces together. Before bringing the pieces together, place the bottleneck inside the holes. Because you cannot insert or remove the bottles once the wood pieces are fixed. Drill a screw hole using a bit matching the screw size and then tighten the screws to bring the 4 pieces together. Decorate the vase using your favorite flowers to make it more beautiful. This will be an unique centerpiece for any table. You can also hang it on a wall by adding a sawtooth hook or by screwing a hook and tying a piece of rope. It is not necessary to decoupage the bottles. You can use it as is or paint a folk art painting on it to give an ethnic look. Hope you have enjoyed this video. Please subscribe and share my channel. Press the bell icon for notifications. Also, leave your likes and comments. Thanks for watching.